Hey guys, today I wanted to show you some tips and tricks how to create songs or chord progressions out of nothing with no knowledge at all, just drawing stuff into your MIDI role editor, and that's all. And we start off by creating one instrument track to make a sound. And we are using the polysynth again. Just tune that a bit down. Okay. That's enough. We are creating one diatonic transposer in front of the polysynth, so we have always correct notes in a scale, and the scale we are selecting is C minor because I like it. We are creating one clip and drawing the first note, and the first note is in C because we are choose C minor here, so we are drawing one C note. Take this one. That's a C. I'm duplicating the content. So we have four bars. And we are starting creating our first chord. How we do this? Pretty easy. Just plain visually. We create one note on top of C here, and one note below. Why I'm choosing this and this note, you ask? Because it looks nice. It looks even. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, we can take this one. This is even. It looks even. It has to be, it has to sound nice too. Playing back. Sounds like a major chord. Okay, we're duplicating this. Take the chord and move it to the last bar. Now we are creating a transition chord. We have to transition from this to this, but now it's like it's the same chord, okay? So it doesn't sound nice. So what we're gonna do is we make this one uneven, a bit disharmonic, and it also looks uneven or odd. Okay, so we have to make some changes to the chord. Maybe move this a bit up and this a bit down. Not too much. So it sounds a bit resolving. And to make this even more uneven, I am using one additional note, maybe here. So it sounds completely off and also disharmonic and a bit resolving. Okay, we're duplicating this again, moving this here in front of this just created chord and make it a bit more harmonic. So we're removing this additional note maybe and trying again. Could be okay. I'm duplicating again. And now we are trying to make a transition from this to this. This note is the same. This note is different. Maybe we put this note closer to this note. So moving it a bit up. Maybe try this one. It sounds okay, a bit boring. Okay, so we can keep making changes. Maybe bringing a bit two sections in here, maybe the first one and the second one, by moving this down. Okay, these two chords are too samey, so we're changing this one a bit more. It sounds okay to me. So it's still a bit boring, but we can keep adding chords into this. How we do this? Maybe we can take this chord, half it in the middle, and duplicating this, and move it a bit in this direction from this chord. We can also half this one. Sounds much better, I think. Okay, we can leave this now and keep adding additional instruments just to make more like a song. But first we are adding one arpeggiator, and this one just take the chords and add rhythmic, rhythmic content to it. Just take three steps and take this, the last and the second out. We're adding some audio effects, in this case one delay. One reverb, just to have some room. Just keep it simple. Don't want to add more stuff. Just simple stuff for the start. Okay, so we have our first chord track. It sounds pretty nice, and we are duplicating this. I'm pressing Command and D. So we have this the same track again, and this time we are changing some sounds. Thank you. again, that's the same chords and the same polysynth. I just duplicated this track and made some small and basic changes just to the rhythm and the sound, so it differs from this one. And we have already some interesting material. Okay, that's nice. I got this melody and this one chords. We're duplicating this melody line again, and this time we are removing the top notes because we want to create a bass line. And this time we change the change the sound to a bass sound. Remove all the delays, make it mono. Kick to this so we have more rhythm. And maybe one clap sound. You have already some harmonies going. That sounds nice, a basic structure, and you can keep going, adding additional stuff, making modulations here and there, adding harmonics, adding sounds, changing sounds, but you can always use the same notes, leave something out, add something, change the rhythm, delays, and so forth, and it's always will be sound nice. And that's how basically club tracks are made these days. So see you next time.